Congressional leaders also want to know much more about what led up to the sudden resignation of CIA Director David Petraeus. Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger sits on the House Intelligence Committee, yet he says he was in the dark about the Petraeus investigation until just hours before it went public. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh is live in the newsroom with the latest. And Carrie, I think that's one of the most surprising aspects of this case, that the president wasn't told, and neither was Congress.
Yes, Donna, that's right, and it's fueling a lot of speculation and intrigue, especially among Republicans who believe this was kept under wraps to protect the president's reelection chances. Meanwhile, a local Homeland Security expert believes the woman Petraeus was involved with may bear the brunt of the fallout.
Former CIA Director General David Petraeus admits his relationship with biographer Paula Broadwell crossed the line. The question is, did their affair jeopardize national security? Broadwell's recent remarks on the Benghazi attack amplified the issue.
Now, I don't know if a lot of you heard this, but the CIA annex had actually had taken a couple of Libyan militia members prisoner, and they think that the attack on the consulate was an effort to try to get these prisoners back. So that's still being vetted.
Officials reveal classified documents were found on Broadwell's computer, but both she and Petraeus denied that he provided them.
It may be that there'll be an investigation into her access in an improper way to confidential, secret information.
The probe began when a Petraeus family friend told the FBI she was receiving threatening emails. The FBI says those emails led back to Broadwell and revealed her affair with Petraeus. Officials say there was no evidence that intelligence was compromised, but some politicians want to know why no one outside of the agency, including the president, was notified before Election Day.
It is very troubling on the face of it. But I think there are a lot of facts that need to be developed.
The head of the University of Maryland Center for Health and Homeland Security says that despite the political firestorm brewing, it appears the investigation did follow proper protocol.
It is not appropriate for the FBI or the Justice Department, while an investigation is ongoing, to be telling third parties about what is happening.
Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger is slated to meet with the head of the FBI and the acting CIA director this week to assess how the investigation was handled, and it continues to develop. Local media outlets in Charlotte are reporting that tonight the FBI is searching the North Carolina home Broadwell shares there with her husband and two children. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.